German doctrine from interwar years had an emphasis on leading from the front. Even generals were expected to be at times present at their Schwerpunkt or main focus in order to understand and to influence the events at the most important location of their area of responsibility. This included all commanding officers and was a major contributor for the extraordinary high attrition among German generals. The approach of having a senior leader at his Schwerpunkt, able to make quick decisions and directly supported only by a tiny fraction of his staff, enabled a very aggressive style of command. It was understood that this would require armored command vehicles in the case of armored formations and units. Battalion and regimental headquarters required such command vehicles. During the war, all German tanks had a radio with a 2 km range. Additionally, the command vehicle had a much more powerful extra set with a 65 km range. The first examples were modified light tanks such as the Kleiner Panzerbefehlswagen or small command vehicle. The armament was reduced to one machine gun, a larger superstructure replaced the turret to offer the necessary space for a decent radio set. Only 184 were produced from 1935 to 1937. This was a great boost for the ability to lead armored formations and units, but the risk involved were too large. The vehicle stood out and was barely bulletproof. Later command tanks were built as slightly modified normal tanks, either with a mock gun or with normal gun. Panzer commanders were then capable of staying in touch with superior HQ and the neighboring unit's HQ via radio while staying in touch with their own tanks at all times. These tanks were called Panzerbefehlswagen or tank command vehicles. Most Panzerbefehlswagen were based on the Panzer III tank. A dummy gun replaced the cannon in order to mimic the appearance of normal tanks for survivability, but they still stood out because of their large antenna sets. Approximately 250 were produced. These proved to be notoriously short in supply. These tanks were not meant to fight, but to command. Nevertheless, a real cannon instead of the machine gun was still desired. With the next model, the Panzerbefehlswagen III variant G, 81 produced altogether, the compromising large frame antenna was finally replaced by a less conspicuous star antenna. It was a 1.4 meter rod with a small star placed on the top. The star antenna not only was cheaper, but it proved to be more effective. The Panzer III series proved unable to mount the powerful 75 mm gun and did therefore lose relevance in late 1942 in favor of the Panzer IV. Panzerbefehlswagen III began standing out among Panzer IV tanks in 1943, and the Panzer IV-based command tank had to be introduced. The Panzerbefehlswagen IV, only 97 converted from normal tanks from March 1944 to September 1944. Finally, even Panzer IV became secondary to the Panzer V Panther, and a Panther-based command tank was built. The Panzerbefehlswagen Panther, 329 converted from normal tanks from May 1943 to February 1945. Last but not least, I have to mention the command variant of the King Tiger. These carried only 63 rounds of 88mm ammunition to provide room to accommodate the extra radios and equipment, and had additional armor on the engine compartment. The Command Tiger variant used the standard command vehicle radio sets, with the most notable external changes being a 2-meter long rod antenna mounted on the turret roof and the famous star antenna set. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe and support my channel on PayPal. Details in the description box.